Hey everyone, you're here with Mark on Perfect Gardens TV. So, got another great question. How about calcium acetate? Chicken egg soaked in vinegar for a couple of weeks, and you got calcium acetate. So, when you're making calcium acetate with eggshells, how you go through this process is first you're going to want to totally sterilize the eggs. So, you'll take the eggs, the eggshells, you'll boil them in water, get all the film, anything like that off, and you just make it basically clean, sterile eggshells. Basically, to the point where all of the membrane gets removed. Once dry, you'll crush them up into a fine powder. After that, you'll begin to add vinegar or acetic acid. That will produce calcium acetate, carbon dioxide, and water. You'll want to add the vinegar slowly to your crushed eggshells. You'll see fizzing, and that's just the carbon dioxide. Keep adding until the fizzing reaction stops. Then you'll want to evaporate the liquid, and you could do that by simply heating it up on the stove very slowly, or you could just put it outside on a hot day on like a black pot, and it's going to evaporate pretty quickly. Then at that point, you have calcium acetate crystals. I know your next question, you're going to be like, okay, well, how much of those crystals should I use? Well, if you're like mixing your own chemicals and you have the isolated chemical, like the calcium acetate, you're going to want relatively around 100 to 200 parts per million. Obviously, you got to pay attention to your plants. If you have calcium, you're going to want to add magnesium in there. You're going to want to add NPK. You're going to want to add drops of balance for the trace minerals. You're going to want to add other things besides just the calcium. If you're using tap water, you're going to want to be aware of how much of calcium is already in your tap water or well water. So there's going to be other factors that are going to be important. But if you're, let's say, just using RO water, for example, and you're using a very low parts per million, you're going to want around 1 to 200 parts per million, and or adjust from there depending upon what your plants are saying to you. Remember, like the law of minimum and the law of tolerance, if you add too much of one thing, it will show up by locking out other minerals. So just be aware of what deficiencies and toxicities look like. And remember that a toxicity could make something appear as a deficiency later. So how much soap would you are going to want to use? Well, calcium acetate has a molecular weight of 158 grams per mole. So what does that mean, right? Well, 100 parts per million means 100 milligrams per liter, which is the same as roughly 100 milligrams in 1,000 grams of water. A gallon of water is 375 grams. So to get 100 parts per million, you will need roughly 378 milligrams of calcium acetate in that gallon. If you want to go to 200 parts per million, you'll need double that to around 757 milligrams. That's roughly 0.757 grams of calcium acetate in distilled or RO water should create a parts per million of around 200 parts per million. Cut that in half for 100 parts per million. And then at that point, you now have ability to create your own calcium acetate, crystallize it so it's water soluble, and you know how much you should use because you're understanding the molecular weight of calcium acetate per mold and how to convert it into milligrams per the amount of water you're using, and then apply it to a gallon and go from there. But the math's been done. You need roughly 0.757 grams in 1 gallon to produce 200 parts per million. Anyways, I hope this video was helpful. Have a great grow, guys.